Good morning, everybody. I just kind of want to give everybody a timeline in reference to this incident, the attempted kidnapping that occurred on Sunday. So we all know this incident happened on Sunday on Mother's Day at approximately 11:45 a.m. A mother and her daughter had just left church at Our Lady of Lourdes, and they were walking southbound on Halifax Avenue from the church when they were approached by the suspect, who was walking northbound on the same sidewalk. As the suspect approached the mother and the child, the mother and child first attempted to step out of the way. The suspect stepped in front of them, so they stepped the opposite way. The suspect does the same thing. She steps in front of them again, at which time the suspect attempted to grab the child, or tried to separate the hands of the mother and child, where a short struggle ensues. The child falls to the ground, and then the suspect walks away from there. Police are called to the scene, and unfortunately we were unable to locate the suspect on Sunday. But thanks to the great follow-up of my investigators, we were able to go out to 732 North Halifax, where we were able to recover some surveillance footage, which is what was released to you all, that shows the suspect and victim and the mom on the sidewalk. So based on that, we were then able to locate the ex-boyfriend of the suspect, which is where all of our information then began to come from. So Monday night, we got a call in reference to a disturbance at that apartment. Upon arrival, the suspect is on scene. There is a struggle that ensues, and we're able to take her into custody. During that struggle, she was tacked on another charge of battery LEO, where she kicked one of the arresting officers. So she already had a warrant for violation of pretrial release in reference to domestic battery and a violation of an injunction. So she was transported out to the jail on those charges. We then coordinated with the SAO, and after speaking with her at the branch jail, she was charged with attempted kidnapping and felony battery. So upon speaking with her, she admitted to her actions. She is a military veteran, and she has a history of mental illness. She actually has a child herself that's been taken from her. She lost custody of her child, and she admitted that she was depressed as a result of it being Mother's Day. So seeing this mom and daughter walking together, that made her very jealous. So it was her, what she wanted to do was basically just to separate the two of them. She said she really had no intent on kidnapping the child, but she was very upset by seeing that mother and daughter walking together. That triggered something inside of her to where she wanted to separate the two of them. So she fully admitted to all of that. There was a lot that I was seeing and hearing about possible human trafficking based on the investigation. This had nothing to do with any form of human trafficking. We're dealing with a mentally ill suspect who is now in custody. So I don't stand here and make any excuses for her actions, but her history is what it is. So that's where we are at this point in time. Any questions?
So she retired from the military?
I don't know how she was discharged, if it was honorably discharged, if she was, you know, kicked out. I don't know. I don't have that information. But I do know at one time she was in the military.
And with the ex-boyfriend in the report, it wasn't entirely clear if they were still together or not. So they've now...
No, so there is a injunction, so they're not supposed to be together, but he admitted that she does come by at some point to pick up clothes. So there was he knew there was a good chance she would show up there Monday night, and when she did, he called us.
And she has a history, you said, she's mental illness history.
Yes.
Also a criminal history, am I correct on that?
Yes, so her criminal history consists of, so she has a criminal history both in Florida and in South Carolina, so she's got everything from marijuana possession, a driving while license suspended, failure to appear. There was an arson that apparently was dropped because they determined that she was mentally unstable to stand trial. Then the violation of injunction, and then, of course, when we arrested her, we tacked on the resisting, as well as also in South Carolina, there's a burglary and a battery.
But you feel fairly confident that she was not, in the true sense of the word, an attempted or a kidnapper, that this was a result of struggle with mental health?
Based on our interview and our investigation, this is definitely a struggle with mental health, yes.
Has she ever had any kind of help with her mental health issues, or has it all just been jail time?
I don't know what services have been provided to her in the past in reference to her issues. We don't have that information.
Does she live, since she's not allowed at her ex's place, which is right there on Halifax, in this area where this occurred, does she live on the street, or do we know?
Ex-boyfriend mentioned that she was staying in a hotel at some point, but it sounds like she's basically homeless.
You said that she didn't have any previous contact with this family?
Say one more time.
She didn't have any previous contact with this family?
No previous contact with this family. Total strangers.
But do you have any concerns, should she find out at some point, that, you know, this, without help, this kind of behavior?
Most definitely, because I think all of her actions and probably the bulk of her arrest are due to her mental status and her being off of her medication. So, yes, because I can tell you, if this were, you know, a parent that was armed, they probably would have shot and killed her for what she did, for attempting to kidnap her child. So for her own safety, something needs to happen here, for her own safety.
And
thank you.
And the child didn't suffer any injuries?
No. Thank you, guys. No, actually, I think she lost a tooth in church. So at one point, you see they stop and take a photo, because she was actually, that was a celebratory thing, because she lost her tooth.
Okay.